We'd like to thank you for joining us today. In light of the recent gun violence acts, we would like to make some changes. We would like to make it clear that this is strictly a student-led protest. Your administrators have had little to no input. We would like to make sure we are staying respectful to them. Our goal today is to reject our voices and make it clear to legislators that we want changes to be made. We would also like to bring awareness of what you guys as future voters can do to make a change. Let our voices be heard. This is our chance. This may not be your traditional gun violence laws and change we can affect.
Not often can you have a rally to do trig calculus. But here's something where you can get involved in government, civics, what they say. I want to start it out with some quotes, if you have me in class. I'm big on quotes. Gandhi, hopefully we've heard of him, right? Be the change you wish to see in the world. You guys want change? Sorry. There you go. I see you as my kids, that's why I can like this. So, you want change, and what you're doing is you're starting with yourself right now. And I tell you guys all the time, as teenagers, you get blamed for a lot of stuff, don't you? You hear millennials do this, teenagers do that. You know, a lot of that fault needs to go on me, needs to go on my generation, needs to go on the adults. And now it's your turn. And say, we've got some problems in this country, regardless of what it is. It's time for you to take a little bit of the blame, adults. And I think, unfortunately, what I've seen is that a lot of adults that are in charge don't want to take any of that blame. They want to throw it back at you guys. But you're here, and I know some of you probably aren't that worried about what's going on, and that's expected. But eventually you will be, and if you want to be that change in the world, like I said, start with yourself. And the next one is Einstein. Smart guy. Hopefully. The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, but expecting different results. There's a school shooting. There's a shooting in a theater. There's gun violence all over the city. Thoughts and prayers. If we give thoughts and prayers, it'll eventually stop. That's insanity. Okay, hopefully you're here to end the insanity that happens every single day, all over the world, all over the country. And we're not here to solve the problem. I don't think you guys being here is going to stop gun violence. It's not going to stop violence. But it's a start. And that's my main thing. We need to start somewhere. Because nobody wants to start because they're not 100% sure how to solve it. I get that a lot when I ask you guys to do some homework and you find it difficult. Some people just, I'm just not going to do that because it's hard, so I'm going to stop. But we want safer schools, we want safer malls, we want safer theaters, we want safer streets, we want a safer society. This is bigger than just Beach Grove or just schools because it happens everywhere. It's like cleaning your room. I've talked about this in class. How many of you just walked into your room one day and it's so messy, I don't know where to start? So I just turn around and I walk out. That's what violence, gun violence is right now. Everybody's looking at that room. And they're like, well, what's making it messy? Well, it's the clothes over here. It's the food, extra food over here. I'm not going to start. We want to point fingers at it's mental health issues. It's we don't have enough God in the schools. It's bad parenting. It's guns. It's a little bit of everything. But what we want to do is just say we're not going to do anything. And I think we're here because we want something, anything to happen. And I hope you do too. Because it's frustrating when people are dying every day and people just sit back and say, well, nothing we do is going to work, so why should we do it? So we're here not to divide people or point fingers. We're here to unite and to get to work on some stuff. Sorry if this is longer than you want it to be. Like I said, I've seen a lot of people tell you guys, you know what, it's okay, just don't be active now, don't do it, you're too young to understand. I know there are a lot of adults in this world who don't understand a lot of stuff, that don't know what's going on, and that doesn't keep them from giving their opinion. And teachers and parents, we're supposed to tell you guys, you can do whatever you want, put your mind to it, and then you're putting your mind to something, and we want to turn around and tell you, don't do it, don't speak out, don't try to get change. You know what? Do it anyway. Do it anyway, except not in my class. And if they don't like it, they need to know there are 27 amendments in our Constitution. Not just one. There's 27 of them. And the 26th gives 18-year-olds the right to vote. So they can disagree with you all they want and tell you don't know what you're talking about. But if you use the tools given to you by this country, the people that don't want the change that you want, they'll sit at home and lose their jobs. and they'll be replaced by somebody that does, and you guys will be the ones to do it. And I've also seen social media say, you know, instead of doing a walkout, kids, why don't you find the kid that might be troubled and go be nice to him? Go talk to him. That'll stop it. You know, I see great things out of you guys every single day. You guys handle so many situations so much better than my generation did, and I don't think that's fair to tell you. If you want change, it's on you. They're pointing fingers at you. Point the fingers right back. Say, you're doing your part. Now, adults, lawmakers, you do your part. Because you are the ones that are getting killed. And I was trying to talk to these guys. Now, you guys need a hashtag for Twitter. Because I'm old, but I know I'm Twitter. I made Twitter not cool because I started using it. I came up with one. It's from one of the greatest musical groups when I was in high school, named Public Enemy. And they had a song called Bring the Noise. Anybody know it? Mr. Cross does, Coach Cross does. And that was about, if you don't like something, bring the noise. And that's what you guys are doing right now, and continue to do it, because I guarantee you, if some people have their way about this, it'll just die down and it'll end. And we'll go on to something else. But if you bring the noise every day, it won't die down. Okay? And I have to do this because I'm a teacher. I'm going to read something from the Declaration of Independence. Everybody, oh, I don't know, it's going to be school. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights. Life, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, derive their just powers from the consent of the governed. I'm going to translate that into English. All right? The government's purpose in this country is to protect your God-given rights. And the first right is life. That if you don't believe that your government is protecting that right, you need to do something about it. And that goes all the way back to the Declaration of Independence. So if you have people that tell you otherwise, they don't want to bang the Constitution all day long, tell them, well, I got documents that say that you as a government need to protect my rights, and if I don't like it, I have the right to change it. And that's what you need to do, that's what I need to do, that's what everybody needs to do, regardless of what it is. If you want more gun control, vote for more gun control if people are going to do it. If you think there needs to be mental health, more help for mental health, do that. Whatever the problem, we're not going to all agree on, but agree that the enemy isn't gun owners. The enemy isn't teachers. It's not students. The enemy are the people who want to do evil. Right? Those are the enemies, not us. Come together and we can do great things.
You are also welcome to stay. This probably, we won't let it go any longer than 3 o'clock. These three individuals are also here. If you guys have any questions for them, feel free to ask them. So if anybody has any questions, now would be the time.
Do you want to say to us?
Games are part of the cause. There is not just one cause. But all of you are here, I hope that you want to stop violence, school violence. Gun control is part of it, but if you study school violence, it's not just guns. You have fights in schools. They use edge weapons as knives. So blame one thing, you can't do it. To help, like has been said, you see something, say something. Find an adult and teacher, make an anonymous call to the police station to give us a chance to help you and to make the school and the city safer.
Thank you. My honest personal opinion is that teachers should teach. And there are numbers and people like you. Individually, you don't have a chance. But as a group, collective group, you have a chance.
Because
what in Parkland, what got kids outside? What got kids outside when he started shooting the fire alarm? So schools have to rethink their fire drills. You've practiced fire drills forever. Back in grade school, middle school, now to high school. Have you ever did an earthquake drill? Now you're going to have to start doing active shooter drills. Isn't that terrible? But that's where we've come to in this country. The greatest country in the world, and we have to resort to this. Yes, you should start doing it. And yes, the school should rethink how they do fire drills.
And we do have, every classroom should have posted, we were given, not necessarily the drill, but our procedures, and that should be posted in every class. So if you're in a classroom, you don't see it, ask the teacher for it, and you should see it from the state police, I believe.
I definitely think that we need to be worrying about prevention and not reaction. So I feel like what a lot of schools are doing is they're teaching students how to react when this happens. They're setting up students to react when this happens. We're not trying to stop it at the root. So we need, like, this is the whole reason why we tried to have this protest today. We tried to stop it at the root. We're trying to spark conversation. So those little papers we get to, those are the numbers of senators, of the representatives, of just using your voice. Even though a lot of us are 18 and we can't vote, you can still use your voice. You can still be powerful in your words, because no one else is going to do anything. We can stop it. Like, we're the only way we can stop this. We're going to outlive these people, so we have to figure out how to do it sooner or later.
Going to do if you're on your telephone tonight and you see somebody's made a threat on social media about the school? What are you going to do? Are you going to tell somebody?
Yeah.
You've got to. Even as trivial as you might think it is, you have to say something to somebody.
A lot of people are scared to say something because they think they're being a snitch, or maybe it's your friend, you're going to get them in trouble. But think about telling on that one person, and then if you don't tell on them, then the impact it can have on a whole bunch of people around. I think that basically concludes it. We were not expecting that many to show up, so we do think that you guys came and took the time stayed more serious about this, because we do come from a small school, but that doesn't mean we can't make big changes, and that just kind of starts here.
So basically, now where we start is what's next, what do we do after this protest, and easily Google search what to do in the legal voting age, and easily spark conversation, ask questions, elect officials. Way that we're going to stop all this death. That's the only way it's going to happen.
And if you are 18, make sure you are registered to vote. Because if you're not going to vote, there's no reason you're going to say anything outside of this. Because we now have, or some of us now have, an actual decision-making ability in who we allow in. So don't say something, run your mouth, and then just not vote.
Teachers, right at the PLC over differentiation will be in briefing in room 119. Right at the differentiation PLC will be in room 119.
How many of you got registered to vote while you're in my class?
Where's your
phone? How
was I? Okay, or you're already registered. If you go through my class in government, I will get you registered to vote. I just got, between the last 2 days, my four government classes, I probably got 40 people registered. But Dr. Hewen shared with me the hotline for bullying that we already have in place, that works the same way. So if you do see